Dobar dan svima. Želim da vas pozdravim ispred Lean Consulting Srbija, da vam poželim dobrodošlicu na današnji webinar pod nazivom Unapredite proces uz metodu Training Within Industry. Hvala vam što ste se prijavili u ovolikom broju. Ovo je peti ovogodišnji webinar koji organizujemo, ovoga puta u saradnji sa TWI Institutom za centralnu Evropu. I ovaj događaj predstavlja početak naše saradnje na tržištu Srbije. Pratite našu LinkedIn stranicu, uskoro vas očekuju nove vesti, ne samo u vezi sa saradnjom sa institutom, već i o novim događajima i obukama koje planiramo u prvom kvartalu 2021. godine. Na početku događaja, pre nego što predstavim današnje govornike i pre nego što nastavimo webinar na engleskom jeziku, hteo bih da navedem nekoliko tehničkih uputstava za sve učesnike. Predviđeno vreme trajanja webinara, kao što ste videli, je 2 sata. Pitanja možete postavljati sve vreme toku trajanja događaja u chatu. I u delu webinara koji je planiran za pitanja i odgovore, na sva pitanja koja ne budu dobila odgovor ili tokom webinara ili u delu za odgovore, sva ta pitanja moći ćete da postavite i naknadno putem adrese elektronske pošte koja će vam biti prikazana na prezentaciji. Link ka upitniku za ocenu događaja će vam biti dostupan u chatu odmah nakon ove uvodne najave za sve učesnike koji zbog drugih obaveza moraju da napuste događaj ranije i na kraju događaja. Zamolit ću vas sve da utišate mikrofone. I poslednja, da kažem, tehnička informacija jeste da će snimak webinara biti dostupan svim današnjim učesnicima, osim u jednom delu koji predstavlja prikaz praktičnog primjera i primjene metode koji zapravo predstavlja poverljive podatke. Ja vam se zaista još jednom zahvaljujem na velikom interesovanju, na svim pitanjima koje smo dobili pre ovog webinara. I eto, nakon ovog kratkog uvoda, webinar ćemo nastaviti na engleskom jeziku. Kao što ste vidjeli u najavi, današnji govornici su Marketa Šimakova, Jitka Tejnorova i Imrih Pap, koji su treneri TWI metode, sertifikovani treneri i predstavnici Instituta za centralnu Evropu, i Miloš Dejanović, koji je uskoro, nadam se, i prvi trener metode u Srbiji, koji će u ovom partnerstvu nastaviti da praktično sprovodi metodu kod nas u Srbiji. Eto, toliko od mene na samom početku i svakako ćemo se opet čuti na kraju webinara. Hello Marketa, Jitka and Imrih, good morning and welcome to Serbia. Thank you for joining us, and now you could proceed with the presentation. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much. Dobar dan, dobri den, good morning to everybody. And say hello from Czech Republic and Slovakia. Thank you very much, Darko, for introduction and also for the possibilities and cooperation to be here together with Lean Consulting Serbia. From our side, what Darko said, my name is Markéta Šimáková and Jitka Tejnorová. We are certified master trainers for TWI, as well as founders of TWI Institute for Central Europe. Imrich Pap is our certified trainer and branch manager of TWI Institute in Slovakia and Hungary, and he's just now responsible as a project leader for Serbia market. And Miloš Dejanović is our new TWI trainer in Serbia, and he's also here. And he will tell you hello also. Miloš, can you introduce yourself? Okay, maybe later on. Fine. What is our purpose for today? Just a short introduction. Our company here in Czech Republic, named DMC Management Consulting, and from 2010 we are exclusive partner of TWI Institute in US. US is IT owner of TWI Methods. And we are the only certified partner for the Czech Republic, Slovakia, Poland, Hungary, Serbia, and Macedonia at this moment. We would like to introduce you short agenda. So first, we will introduce what is TWI, what is the history, what is the philosophy, which methods use in TWI. And after that, we would like to speak more about the job instruction that you can also see a practical illustration. And we have prepared case studies also for job instruction, how used by our clients. So let's start. We will check also chat. Please, if you have any question to me or Jitka or Imrich, can you write it in English, because we don't understand in Serbia well, so we understand, but we are not right, definitely. And I will try to answer during our presentation, and now I would like to give the word to Jitka.
So hello, I would like to start a little bit to explain what is a TWI. TWI, as you can see, is a training within industry. And very shortly to show what are the benefits of the methodology. The first part of TWI is work standardization, increasing productivity or efficiency, faster training of people, work safety, improved discipline, and finally problem solving. It is the main points of TWI. TWI is a key to real work standardization. This is a dynamic program of practical training, improving skills of supervisors and all who lead teams. The training is conducted directly at the workplace with immediate implementation of gained skills. It means that we are not working with the theoretical methods or theoretical things. We are working directly with the people on their workplace. So I would like to introduce a little bit TWI history, because we are very proud of that. TWI, like a method, was developed during the Second World War. The war production was lacks train staff, and they needed to very quickly and effectively train the, especially women, for the new production, for war production. You can see the first picture. We can do it. It is the first promotion materials of TWI method, when the women came to the work without any experience, without any qualification. Sometimes I say that in our country, or maybe in Serbia, we are also on the same situation, that the new technology is increasing and we don't have qualified people. So during the fifth and sixth years, TWI method gets to Japan, and it started to be a fundamentals of Toyota production system. And in Europe and US was a little bit decreasing, but you know, for example, McDonald's or the traditional companies, they are using TWI until now. In the 90s, our senior master trainer, Patrick Graup, found the method in Japan. He was trained there, and he brought the method back to USA. And in 2001, he established TAA Institute USA, and he started to develop the method for, let's say, the Western culture and for Western situations. And also, I would like to tell or speak a little bit about the TAA Institute Central Europe. We were founding together with Marketa. We recognized what is TWI during our cooperation with Toyota, Peugeot, Citroën in 2003. And we were passionate for that because it was very easily working method to help continuous improvement, to train people and to build culture in the companies. So we were searching for the method, and we started with the part of the method in 2006, and we developed Supervisors Academy, focused on the especially shift supervisors to increase their key competencies. From 2010, we established TWI in Czech Republic, and we developed all methods from TWI focus. In 2014, we established TWI in Slovakia, so then Poland, so then TWI Institute Central Europe. In 2018, we were trained in Japan for standardized work. And in 2019, we have started the first training in Serbia. And we are glad that one of the participants of our training from company Grundfos is right now here as a guest of our workshop. So this is the very short introduction of the history, but what I wanted to say that we have until now, from 2010, trained more than 3,800 people for 120 companies from different industries. How TWA method is working? Let me introduce you the five needs of supervisors. It is a basic point of TWI. TWI is working with five needs, five, let's say, knowledge and skills of each leader or each supervisor. The first knowledge is the knowledge of the work. It is something what we cannot train. It's something what is necessary to be learned during the organization. Also, there is a second knowledge of responsibilities of each leader. It is a very unique for each company because every company has a very specific rules and politics and culture. And this is something that is necessary also to teach the people. And three skills we are speaking about. The first, and we will introduce you today, is skill in instructing. This is a part that we call job instruction. And this part, this module, taught supervisors how to effectively train others to perform jobs. Second part is skill in improving methods. It's called job methods training, and it is a fundamentals of Kaizen activities. And this module taught supervisors how to break down jobs to so they could better improve the jobs. And the third of the skill is a job relations skill in leading. And this part, job relations, taught supervisors how to manage a workplace and how to handle problems with the people. To have to use that skills or across that skills, you can see inside is something what we call safety. All of you know that safety first. It's a going across the excuse me, we have some problem with Oh. Yeah, very sorry. The sharing was interrupted and we needed to go back. So I was speaking about safety. Why safety is inside the circle? It is because of safety you can see in all of that five needs. You know that the knowledge of the safety rules, understanding your responsibilities in safety, you need to train people in safety. Also, you improve a lot of things for safety of people, or you are looking or analyzing the risks for people. And also you handle a lot of problem about the safety. It means that safety is inside the circle. And the job safety is the fourth part of TWI, and it's a providing framework for supervisors to engage them in identifying potential problems and how to Kaizen in safety. They are the four basic modules of TWI, and these modules are working with the key skills, skill in instructing, skill in leading, skill in improving, and safety. And the last, not least, is attitude. Because you can have skills, you can teach the people, but without the attitude, you will not be successful in any project. And this attitude is keeping by special training or special philosophy as a Toyota Kata. Toyota Kata taught supervisors how to coach people to continuous improvement. So I would like to ask right now our colleague Imrich Papp. He has prepared for you some practical example of TWI job instruction, and I would like to ask him just now to take over.
Okay, Jitka, so thank you so much. Hope that you are listening to me very well. And I need to tell you at the beginning that I feel really happy to have the opportunity to share the passion against or to methodology TWI, especially job instruction module, which is one of my favorites. Hope within the next few minutes you will absolutely understand why. Okay, let's see the slide you can see on your screens. And let me tell you that many times it happens if I'm leading a different project in different companies, I always can hear round and round that we have some obstacles, we have some problems, and so on. And with the special topics, like you can see on the screen, that people do not keep the standards. Scrap and rework is really high. We have low or we have no efficiency. Training is not standardized. Capacity is not planning, or we have the problems with the planning of these things. And of course, the fluctuation during the adaptation is really high. I think most of you also are having the same problems or the obstacles, but I have a good news for you. That these problems are connected to each other, because it's really easy to solve this kind of the problems. To solve, but to solve just and only together with the employees, and with the employees which are, I can say, motivated and absolutely well trained. So this is the reason why I really like job instructions, because it's not just about the teaching, but it's about much more. Let's see and let's think about who we have to exactly train in a different companies. Mostly, if I lead this question, everybody is answering me, we have to teach the newcomers. It's absolutely true. Yes, because the newcomers are somebody, who for him all the operations, all the activities could be new, and we have to teach them if they will be responsible for these activities for the future. But of course, please and do not forget to the second group of the people that are the current employees, and job instructions is really hard in this that is thinking not of about just the new employees, but also of about the current employees, which also we have to train. We have to train if there are some promotions. We have to train if there are some transfers. We have to train them also if there are some changes in the production, changes in the technology, changes in the standards, or whatever you think. And that's why we are using exactly the job instructions. But what is job instruction? Jitka told you a little bit a few minutes ago, but I would like to tell you something else, that if I always have this question, somebody's describing me or the people are describing me, job instruction is maybe a standard which is written somehow, or job instruction is, let's say, a documentation for the operations and so on, maybe, but it's not absolutely true. Please, in TWI, the job instruction is the way, so again, the way to get a person to quickly remember to do a job correctly, safely, and conscientiously. And that's why we are using the job instructions. By using the job instructions in a correct way, you will be able to effectively delegate the work and instruct the people. You will be able to make shorter the training time. You will be able to improve the performance, improve the quality, eliminating the waste in the production and the reworks, of course, and there will be less accidents and improve the job satisfaction. So how does it really work? I would like to show you, and today we exactly prepared for you three typical demonstrations, where we would like to show you how do we exactly train the people. Today, you can see...
Excuse me, Berce, I would like to have some information for the staff. I'm so sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. So, I would like to ask right now Darko to stop recording, and I would like to explain to our guests, this part is a part of TWI training, and it is not allowed to make any recording with our presentation. Thank you very much for your understanding.
Okay. So, as I told you at the beginning, it is the methodology that we call the four-step methodology. So we created also, or we just run through the total instructing within these four steps. At the beginning, of course, I put the person to ease, which was quite necessary to do. Then after, what happened, Jitka, I stated the job, but not to the details, not to the details. The third thing that I did, it was to find out what she already knows. Do you remember, have you ever done any of the knots in your life? The fourth point was get the person interested. It's a simple job, but it's a really important job. The fifth point was place in the correct position. I asked her just to sit next to me quite much closer. So the first step, standardized step during the job instruction is prepare the worker. Then after, we just run through and start with the second step. Tell, show, and illustrate the important steps. Not more, just an important steps at the beginning, which we had five. The second point was that I again tell, show, illustrate, and tell also not just the important steps, but of course, maybe a little bit more detailly with the key points. The third one was when I show it, that I did it again, and tell, show, and illustrate again the important steps, the key points, and the reasons for the key points. Why like this? So the second step during the standardized way is absolutely to present the operation three times. Let's go away. And then after I just ask Timmy just to sit onto her place, we change the position, and I ask her to make her first underwriter knot, but absolutely in a silence without any work. So have the person to do the job in without words. The second point was when I asked her to make it once again, but with explanation of the important steps. The third one was just to make it again and to tell me, to explain me the important steps and together with the key points. And the fourth demonstration of her was to make it again and to tell me, explain me the important steps, the key points and the reasons for the key points. So the third standardized step during the job instruction methodology is trying out the performance. And then after, when it was a 100% job, I didn't leave. I had also some other points. For the first, what I tell, that I just put the person on their own. I explain to her what is waiting on her with the plastic bag, with the thousand of pieces of the cables and so on. The second point was that I designate who to go for help. There was Annette, the most experienced, because I have to leave, but she will be no alone. The third point was to check on the person frequently. I explain to her when I will come back, I will do something, and it will be, of course, I will try to correct her and help if she will need some other support. The fourth point was just encourage the questions. So I just ask her, before I will leave, Timmy, you have any other questions regarding the job or something else? And the last thing that we did together was the taper of extra coaching, closing the follow-up. So together, these 5 points you can see here, we call during the TWI job instructions model, that is the step of the follow-up. And as you can see, these 4 points are the standardized 4 steps of the job instruction model, how to lead the instructing or the training of the people. This is the reason why we say that if the worker hasn't learned, it means that the instructor hasn't taught. Timmy was able to do it, so it was the success, not only just her, but it was also the success of mine. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And now I'm just returning the words back to Jitka or Markéta. Thank you.
So thank you very much, Imrich, for a very perfect demonstration how job instruction really work. And just now we have a time for questions, because we are before the cases introduction, and I would like to ask you if you can write to chat some questions, because you saw probably TWI method using job instruction on the first time, and maybe you can have some additional questions. Please don't hesitate to write it to chat. And during the time we will be waiting for your questions, I would like to explain that the standard of 4 steps method is using in all of the clients. We will speak later on during a cases presentation. It means that each of our client doing that that job are using similar or same standard as Berci Imrich show. So we have the first question. Can you please provide an example of how this can be applied to creative service industries? Yeah, it's a perfect question, because in creative work also you have probably 50-70% of standards and standardized jobs, repeating jobs, what is necessary to keep. And if the people, creative people, are using the 80% of standards, they have a much more time to be creative, because they are sure in the standard work. And it means that it is working very well also in a creative environment. So second question, is there any time measurement either with stopwatch of or MTM which follows job instructions? Yes, perfect question. Thank you, Vladimir. Yes, we are starting measurements from the first moment of the implementation of the method, because you can measure a lot of KPIs, and you can also measure performance, you can measure time of training, and you can measure also the time of operation you are really able to do. I can tell you before the cases that 80-70-100 of our clients had the first newcomers up to 100% of performance until 1 hour. And it was quite amazing. Other question, is it possible to make a group training? You know, it is a very common question. TWI is working with one-to-one training because as you could see, also Imrich did not just train Timmy, but he also made some job relations. He also showed her that he is her team leader and the person who she can trust and who she can ask for some questions. It is a part like a combination of hard and soft skills together. And we strictly recommend to do just one-to-one training. How job instruction in this example should look like in paper form? Thank you very much for the question. It is something what Berci can show you. You can see on the desk, he has some papers. And also part of the TWI training is to write down, break down job of job instruction. It is the basic part to be sure that we have that paper standardized in the company. But be careful, this paper is not for operators, it's just for team leaders or trainers, because it's a help how to really use the same standard, even if we have a 5, 10, 15, 20 trainers, they are using same words, same order on proper way. Okay, it seems to me that this method for development of such job instruction is more suitable for manual work with a with a lot of small hands body motions than to making a bus in chemical industry. Is that right? I think that the demonstration was deeply focused on very short and quick demonstration of the job. But we have very good experience also with, let's say, long and large operations and also not repeated operations. For example, we have very good experience with Setters Academy making within TWI. And also we use that for like a part of a SMET. If we do change of die, we also need to make some standard points people should follow after their during their activities. It means it's possible to use it also in a bigger parts or machining. I have that help from Marketa here. Yeah, it's also working, but it's necessary to evaluate that method, but still keep the same four-step standard. So, okay, questions are right now stopping. No, okay, thank you very much. How sustain knowledge of operators on the workstation? I think it's the also the question. Marketa will speak more about it during her case from Bosch company. The sustaining is a standard as for other methods. It's a necessary to have a system, to have some visualization, and also to have some control or audit points, and it's a process control part. Do you practice sharing written materials with the employees after the presentation session with the trainer, or do you leave it on the verbal presentation only? I think this is the two parts. The job breakdown Bersil showed you is the paper for trainers, but of course for operators we have to have some documents, job instruction or some other instructions, some work leads. What is a good that during the training, one-to-one, we also teach the operator how to use that documentation. You know, for example, you have some control document and during the key point control that, we can show the document, use this control document, for example. But yes, it is a necessary still keep job instruction on the workplace, for sure. Do we need to have job instruction in front when a training employee is there are any standard of how many steps do we need to have in job instruction? You know, we have that tricky recommendation. When the training is longer than 20 minutes, it means that the brain is not able to have it. It means that we do the steps as possible for person to do it. And if the operation is longer, we cut it for some shorter parts and we train the person part to part. It's an experience and it's working very well. Can video job instruction be used instead of living presentation by trainer? For example, you have new workers in 3D shift without trainer available. You know, this is the modern technology is coming with that possibilities also with in 3D or something like that. I would say that video is also a very good part of the training, but still not without the trainer, you know, because that personal touch to new operator is giving you increasing of loyalty and increasing of teamwork in the company. So we use, for example, video for operations which are not repeating or not easy to repeat more times. For example, I use it for the setters when they are change the die and change the die 3 times and 4 times. It's quite difficult for the machine. And then we use the video for a presentation, but still trainer was there. Mm-hmm. So other question, one comment, in ZF we use your method in your example. It may have been better if there was a description of what to do with the left hand and what with the right hand. Yeah, that's a perfect. Thank you very much. I know that in ZF also we have a very good experience with implementation, especially in Slovakia. They have a perfect training center prepared for that. Using the left hand and right hand, there is the question for Columbus, you know, because sometimes you need to mention left or right. Sometimes it is not necessary. It is up to the necessity of the job. In that part, you could see that she was supervised by the person. She was placed on right side position, and it means that she's so what kind of hand to use. But for some operations like assembly, sometimes you need the person instruct, use the left hand, and then it is a key point. You're right. Do you divide the whole task to VA and NVA work? I think that the job instruction is working with the standard we currently have. It means that when we will go to job methods, during the job methods breakdown, we are dividing the operations to not value and not value added, value added and not value added activities. And after that, we make a new standard, and that standard is in the job breakdown. It means that every company has a standard, and even if that standard is not perfect and could be improved, every time could be improved, yes, we are working with that, but in job instruction, we instruct people, do it on that way, even if it is not valid, not a value-added activity. Do you divide, is there any difference in a job instruction if you have employees that are left or right-handed? Perfect question. For some operations, yes. For example, I remember from Hartmann company that for cutting, it's not possible to change the person. So some activities need to be prepared for the left or right-handed people. Some activities you need to really keep standard. It means that left or right-handed people should be instructed on proper way. But it is a necessity to make analyze of the job if it is possible for left or left-handed people. Yeah, perfect question. And we are sometimes asking if the position is difficult for left-handed people. We are asking during the step number one, as Berzi was asking Timmy, what's your experience or what did you do? Include that question. Yeah, okay. Are you left-handed or not? If yes, I will show you the proper way for left-handed people. Okay, so, super. We have the question. Thank you very much for your initiatives, because I am very happy for questions. To speak to online is not really very easy, because I feel that I am alone here together with Markéta. So we have a last question. Do you use color in job instructions to connect steps or key points with pictures? Definitely, yes. Of course, Betsy show you the just the standard document for training, but in the real real job, we use also pictures. We use also some small pictures to like alert or be careful or something like that. Yeah. So we can continue with the second part. I would like to just shortly explain you how TWI method is fitting together with a lean, because sometimes we have a lot of questions why we present TWI in a lean, and there are the three short slides to explain. I would like to repeat again that TWI is a fundamental of Toyota production system, and the current TWI method as we teach is totally developed in Japan in 50s, 60s. And you can know probably, or should know probably the words of Taichi Ono from Toyota: without standards, there can be no improvement. And no goal, regardless of how small, can be achieved without adequate training. That is the first part of lean, of Toyota production system. Just the standards can be improved, and it's necessary to train the people to be sure that they are able to keep that standards. Even if you improve something without that training, without effective training, your improvement will be very quickly falling down. We can see that in other part. Lean strategy is definitely built up on that two basic points: standard work and daily management. Standard work, it is the best possible work method with the least amount of waste, producing the best quality product at the lowest cost. And second, daily management, it is the structure for putting standards in a place and continuously improving. It's the part or fundamentals of lean. So why tactical lean doesn't work? It is something what we definitely know from our experiences. You do some lean event, you see very quickly some growth, some increasing of performance or increasing of quality, but during the time that performance and results are falling down, you know, and then we have to start new event. We are again very successful with a new event, and time to time and after time the results are again falling down. Why? Because we need the standardization for that new standard we have created during the event. This is the last part, how lean and TWI are fitting together. We have the last question I would like to answer. Where should we keep work instruction, in front of employee or in documentation? You know, I have a very good experience, especially from the assembly jobs. For assembly jobs, for that high performance job, it is a necessity to have that key documentation as close as possible to operator. What I have a very good experience with the screens directly on the workplace, and on the screens are just the key points, just the critical things we would like to show. But for example, for setters, it's better to have documentation in documentation, you know, because they are just using that manuals for sometimes and for some difficulties, for example. But for standard, they usually use the standard from their routine. So Now it's a time to show you case studies. Thank you very much. And I would like to right now to ask for Marketa's part, because she would like to show you our examples from the clients and the successful implementation of TWI. Thank you very much.
Okay, so let's continue. We have prepared just three, four case studies because we have no time enough, but I hope we will continue in January and we will have opportunities to introduce more. We have been working with a lot of companies. Also, somebody asked if it's just for the manual work or just for production. Of course not, because we work with a lot of industries. The first job in TWI in 2010 here in Czech Republic was mostly oriented for medical and pharma. We have started with the biggest producer of the medical and pharma parts. It was Hartmann, Ricoh and Olympus. You will see some case studies from this company. And after that, we continue mostly with the automotive, because of course, in Czech Republic and Slovakia, we are the biggest automotive producer and supplier. So, but a lot of another industry as plastics production, precision, electronics, food and beverage, which is also very important. And this year or the last year, we have started in services and retail, because in services and retail is a lot of standardized work and people need to have a training also because of the fluctuation point and also for the improvement point, because a lot of retail companies started with the improvements and they are very motivated to do it as an automotive, because automotive is them or there for them the biggest the player in the improvement, of course. So this is the answer maybe for question which industry or where TWI is relevant. We are sure everywhere, because just now you see the situation with the COVID, and also in the US this methodology and job instruction and standard is used in healthcare, it means in hospitals. How to train nurses and also the doctors to follow the standards during some operations. And this is what Jitka said at the beginning. So this is very important, because they have some standards, and for us important that nurses and doctors will be healthy, because we need them in the hospitals. And we have to teach them how to use just now, for example, the gauzes and something in the new way, in the new method, because this is something new for them in the COVID situation. So this is the answer where we can use TWI. We can use it anywhere, because we have standards anywhere, of course. We have prepared some case studies, so we will speak more about the Bosch, because we cooperating with the Bosch a lot of years, not just in Czech Republic, but also in Hungary. So it means that we will have two case studies, and also we invited Bosch for the junior workshop to introduce more about TWI using. We have been working here in Robert Bosch since 2015. Maybe you can say this a lot of years, but of course Bosch is a huge company. They have a lot of operations, and also we are using the methods continuously. It means that we cannot start with the job instruction, job relations and job methods in the one time, but we have to implement step by step. So we are working there on job instruction, job relations, also kata and job methods at this moment. I have prepared short results and case study from job instruction, because today we are speaking more about job instruction, but the next time you can see also some results of job relations. As Jitka said, everything we can measure. So if we train the people, we are measuring a lot of points. We are measuring the fluctuation, we are measuring also the efficiency, we are measuring the quality of the new employees, because the goal is that we have to teach the people anywhere as soon as possible in the right way, because we need from them the right outputs. So we have started with a job instruction in one of the operations of Robert Bosch. It was the Ferrele. I don't know if you know what's this Ferrele. It's just the cables to the power to the gas. And we have started there because they had a lot of mistakes and errors, which was achieving by operators. And also we were more oriented for the performance, line performance. And you can see here some outputs from them. They were able to increase of line and performance by 8% during 6 months. And thanks to training operators and improving standardized work, because the standard was not correct in this time. Also achieving zero complaints due to operators' errors and mistakes. It was the result from the training. I remember one of the operation, it was very easy operations with the O-rings, just three steps. How to do that, but they this O-rings is the most important in Ferrele, because sometimes you can see the car that they are firing. So this is the reason, because the O-rings are not right. And we change the standardization of this. We train the people for this, and they had zero complaints after the training. So it was perfect. And the third point, of course, is the implementation of a transparent training process. It means that each of the team leader, each of the trainer is able to train the people in the same way. It's standardization for everybody. If you start as a new operator in the company, you are trained for some operations in line, and second day you are going for the another line, you can be sure that each of the team leader will train you in the same way, because they have a standard. Of course, this is part of continuous improvement, because if we start to change the standard, we are asking all the time for some questions, what we are doing and how we are doing and why, what is the reason? Could we do it in another way? So a lot of companies told me, so we are starting with a standard, with a job instruction, but we have a lot of improvements. So we were able to increase offline performance, not just because we trained operators in the right way, but also we could change something, because a lot of companies, and maybe you can tell me this one also, has a lot of control points, because we are very afraid, because we are afraid of the errors and mistakes. But a lot of control points are not important. This is from the historical point. So we were able to change the standard and also improve the process. So you can see here, and this is the answer for one of the questions in chat, how to work with this method, because you can have a million methods, and if the people don't understand, they are not trained well for the methods, we can have a problem. And also the control and audits of the methods are important. So I don't like the word audit, of course, but a lot of companies have a LPA audit or LPC audit. It means that we control and verify the process control in the operations. And the part of this is the implementation of a job instruction, that we need to have a visualization. It means that each of the team leader you can see here has a planning of the training. They have a plan, because if we want to train people effectively, we have to plan. We have to have some planning, how we retrain the people, how many times, when, for which operations, how we can increase the flexibility and capability of the people. So this important thing is visualization, and it managed by team leader and supervisor, nothing else. It means that, yeah, if I'm going as a manager for this, so I can okay. Also, the part of instruction is okay. Somebody has a microphone, so you, yeah, thank you. Just GI structure and role.
Because if we train just the people as a team leader to be JR trainers, it's not enough, because we can train them. They can follow the four-step standards, what you see from Emrich before. But if nobody coach them and control them and improve their skills, this is the follow-up of what Emrich said, it's not possible to do it. So each of the person in the structure, from top management to low management to operators, has to be part of this structure, because each of them, they have a some role. The production manager and head of production, how to name, they are the main coaches, and they have to be trained how to coach the people. Also, the supervisor is coach. A lot of supervisors, they don't know, they have no skills how to coach the people. If I want to have a good line leaders or team leaders, they have to be managed. They have to be coached. And also very important part is process engineering. This is the reason why also the question for your chat, because we have a breakdown sheets. We have a job instruction or manual, which is sometimes very complicated because process engineers are not part of the training and they are writing story in a manual and nobody uses it because nobody has the time to read. And if they read, they don't understand. If we have a process engineering technologies, part of TWI, part of job instruction, they are able to write the documentation also through the job instruction, through the breakdown sheets. It means important step, key points and reasons. And also they are able to put there very good pictures. So my experience from Bosch is that they were able to absolutely change the documentation to be much more easy. Because if I have easy documentation, I am able to train easy and effective way. So this is also a very important answer how we can use the job instruction. No just trainers, but everybody has to be involved for this. This is about the structure, and now I will give the word to Emrich again, Berci. He will continue with a case study in Bosch in Hungary, because we cooperated together with them, and they also shared their results, and it's a long-term cooperation. So if you have any question, please write questions, and after case studies, we will again answer for your questions.
Okay, so thank you very much, Markéta. Yes, it's absolutely true that they just gave us many, many of information for these case studies, but I would like to tell you that more deeply through the process of the implementation of TWIJI, we will see in January, because we invite them for the workshop, and absolutely the Bosch told us okay, and they will present you how do they proceed with the implementation and how do they work with this methodology. But for the first, let me say you a little bit that what was the reason why TWI was start in Robert Bosch in Hatvan in Hungary. The most important is that still they are telling that they would like to achieve all the goals. They would like to achieve the success always with the people. They understood really good that without the people, they will be never successful. They would like to improve, of course, but the improvements are coming just and only with the systematic problem solving. The systematic problem solving is coming with the defining of the problems. To be able to define the problems is coming just and only with the well-trained people. So that was the reason why they have already chose this methodology, because they heard of about it in 2016 and we start the first project in 2017. Also, the reason was that they would like to prepare the workers for an effective training. Many times we are speaking of about the effectivity during the trainings, but what does it mean? To be to have a shorter training time, or to be able to understand the operation, or what does it mean? everything. I just showed you a few minutes ago during the demonstration that how do we proceed, how do we work with this methodology in this way. Then improve the skills of the employees. Jitka yesterday showed you that what is the difference in between the knowledges and in between the skills. So one of the tasks was to improve the skills in instructing of the employees. And of course, one of the most important thing was the coaching and the feedback culture. To standardize these kind of things, not only just to do something, but to really able to see what happened and always following these outputs, how to create, how to plan the next step. It's quite something similar that it's another tool like the PDCA when you are planning, doing, checking and acting and so on. But time by time and how it is running, now it seems that in the Bosch they are using much more than PDCA. It's not a PDCA, it's literally the PDSA, which is not about the checking, it's about the studying process. It's absolutely easy to plan, it's absolutely easy to use, and it's absolutely easy to check, so you will be able to improve. That was another reason. Teach the trainers where and how to divide. You also saw a few minutes ago that I did a content together with Timmy, which was not longer than 15 minutes. And also Jitka told that an effective training should be done within 20 minutes because after 20 minutes, your brain is not able to work with the data, so much data. So in this case, we also checked that the operations, that the positions and so on, how to divide the content to be able to train, to teach for the people. Increase the autonomy, of course, the autonomy of the trainers, because if everybody knows what to do, how to do it, and they are really good in it, in the training process, in the instructing, it's also increasing the autonomy with this. And delegate and share the tasks and the responsibilities. Marketa shows you on the before slide. With the training, with the or with the trainers, with the coach, and with the champion, and all the other leaders' responsibilities with the structures, you can work successfully. So they were absolutely focused on a long-term strategy, and it seems to be okay because since 2017 they are really successful. But they would like to be better, better, and better. And nowadays it seems that we didn't end with the implementation in the whole factory with the JI, but it's running. The rollout is running really well, but they are also thinking of about the other modules. And in 2021, we will start with the job relation and with some other projects for improving. Systematic and standardized way. I think I don't need to speak of about this more because you heard from Marketa and Jitka. But what is really important is this way. With the TWI, you are able to make a self-regulation of the trainers, self-regulation of the trainees, self-regulation of the processes, self-regulation of technologies or whatever you want. You every time could see that what did you achieve, what did happen, to study, to learn something from that, and then after to plan your next step. And the last thing is the easy connect with the other methodologies and philosophies. I need to tell you the truth, also in Bosch, they are not using just and only TWI-JI. Of course, for the instructing, yes, but it's really easy to connect it with some other lean tools or some other philosophies such as like Kata, or also they are using in Bosch in Hungary the MTM, they are using the Tachimbo and so on, and some basic steps of the Kata as I told you. So this is the first thing that I would like to show, or I showed you that why did they choose this kind of methodology. Okay, so in 2017 we prepared the first pilot, for them. But let me tell the truth, that time it was just a little bit of trial for them because they heard of about the TWM methodology and they would like to try it, whether if it's really of about the standardized work, of about the standardization, and they would like to see how does it work. So that time we lead it on the training center, which one was not a usual training center. It was a training center of the professional trainers. It means that the trainers who are preparing each of the workers for a different department, for a different lines after the classic training center. There were 12 participants, and I need to tell you the truth. Till now, all the participants are working in Bosch and working with TWM methodology successfully. So the only goal was to improve their skills. But in year 2019, we did the second pilot project, especially in the production area. I cannot tell you right now because I'm not allowed to tell you on which value stream, but you will see it in January, of course. With 10 participants, we lead it and we start working with the, through the pilot area. And since that time, from 2019, they did successfully the rollout in 2 of the 4 halls. So I would like to show you just and only the results for the second pilot. And the second pilot approximately takes, you can see, 1.5 year, and it's still not at the end, but we have some outputs from that time. The number of the trainings of this on this value stream was 8 before. Nowadays, it is 26 job breakdown sheet. But what is interesting, maybe you can say 8 and now 26, it's much more, it's longer and so on. No, it's not true. It's effective. It's much more effective because, as you can see, before they didn't know how long does it take. Now it takes the time of the training 316 minutes, which is absolutely standardized. But time for the adaptation was before 3 to 5 months on this value stream. Nobody knows. They told me it depends on the newcomer, it depends on the trainer and so on. And that's it. Nowadays, it's standardized. The total adaptation time is 74 days. It doesn't mean that after 74 days, somebody will able to work. He will able to work on all, on each of the value stream operations. But from the after the first training on the first day, he is a value-added person, and this is important for us. There was no training matrix before. Now it's absolutely set. It's divided into 26 job breakdown sheets within the 74 days. Success during the newcomers, please. This is the number for the fluctuation. -5.5%. There are 3 ships working together, 72 employees. So you can simple count that -5.5%. How much is it? But the fluctuation decreases with this percentage. Flexibility, it's another thing, and this is really good to see in the Bosch company that they are not thinking of about the job instruction just like for the trainings of the newcomers, but also for the current employees. They increase the flexibility to 1.4 times more than it was before. And for them, it is much more better to work with this because it, if there is some failure, somebody is missing, somebody is, let's say, out of the production, needs to go somewhere to the doctor and so on, there is always a flexibility and then knows who is the able person can work on that operation, on that position. And the OEE is +2.4. It's quite hard to say that it's just and only because of the job instructions, but I need to tell you, the job instruction and the good training has a deep impact on the quality, on the changeover, on the people motivation, and so on. And these all the things are increasing the OEE. So this is the result. And the last thing, the last number that I would like to show you, that there was no structure before, but now, as Marketa said, and it's absolutely standardized for all the project, all the implementation in Robert Bosch, they have 2 champions during this second session, 1 coach of the each of the ships on the value stream, and the trainers. But the trainers are not working just like the trainers. They are simple operators, but in time, when it's necessary to train somebody, you absolutely know who is the trainer, who is able to train, following the standardized 4-step processes. So this is my case, and I promise you that in January, from the participants, from Robert Bosch from Hungary, you will hear much more during the total process, how to prepare the company, how to involve the people on each of the levels, how to set the goals, how to run, how to make the pilot and the rollout, how to measure, and how to plan the next steps for the future. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Imrich. I'm very happy from that sharing, and also I'm very happy that the clients are open to share. And I would like just now to show you also other results from non-automotive industry, because it is a very common question Of course, automotive industry is very lean, too lean. But in other services or other production, other industry, we have also very good results, perfect results. We have the first from Hartmann Rico. You can see that after just the one pilot, it was improved effectiveness of training from 40 hours to 20 up to 30 hours, depending on position. It means that for some positions, it was a 50% of decrease of the training time. Decrease of complaints was year to year lowered by 50%. And it was also setting a launch job rotation. It means it was increasing flexibility in lines, and standardized job procedures was explained to all operators. €8. And after implementation and after the launch of TWI, it was decreasing till €6 per one piece. It was quite a big decrease of the results. I'm sorry, I was muted my computer. So other example is from Olympus. Marketa also mentioned. You can see again that we measure during all the time of implementation and also longer. Decreasing scrap on pilot line was a 46%. Training was a faster by 22%. And complete training before TWI was 1 month, and after TWI was 1 week. Even if you could see the Bertis demonstration with Tammy, it should be long and so difficult, but you can see that if the training is well planned and structured, you can really decrease the time for training new people very, very quickly. Average scrap rate on operation before was 4.78 and after 1.32. And also there was a setting all standards for training, and also it was a hugely improved communication and cooperation between technicians, internal trainers and operators. And the last short example is again automotive, but I wanted to show you, it is the Tier 1 automotive industry. I'm not allowed to say the name because we don't have the client here. Results on a pilot line from 18 ppm to 5 ppm, just for pilot line. Extended complaints from 4 ppm to 0. Scrap was decreasing from 1.94 to 0.98, and fluctuation was decreasing from 18% to closely 3%. I think that the results of TWI, thanks to measurements, are really, really huge. So we have a lot of examples from different industries, and I think that there is a good time for you to again to ask for the questions. And also, if you are interested to see some examples from other industries, don't hesitate to contact Imrich Pap, our project leader for Serbian market, and we can prepare for you individual meeting and also to explain you or show you some other results. So can you just now write to the chat your questions, and we can speak much more about that results and how we measure or something like that. So we are waiting just now for the questions, and because we are 15 minutes until the end of our starting workshop, we would like to invite you for January 26. We would like to be more focused on job instruction again, but we will have much more time. You can see that we have a timing from 1 to 5 p.m. Sorry for that afternoon timing, but we are very glad that the keynote speaker of January webinar will be Patrick Grau, the developer, senior master trainer of TWA Institute, and the developer of the method. It is perfectly for you to see directly from him. Also, we are very glad that Grunfu Serbia and Robert Bosch Hungary will present their cases much more deeply, because we did not have a time today to go through whole process of implementation, what they did. And also, I think it's good for you to hear how they were working with TWI. So we are looking forward to seeing you on January 26. We are very happy that Lean Consulting Serbia was in a partnership with us. And we would like to also announce that we are preparing together with Darko some other webinars for next year. And these webinars will be directly focused on each module. It means that we are starting on January with job instruction. Later on, we will do job relations cases. Then we will do job methods. Also, we would like to open Kata webinar, because we understand that Kata is the main method for sustainability of any methods. And also we will open job safety part and standardized work. So questions are not coming now. If we don't have any questions, I would like to, okay, do you use some software for tracking and monitoring training process? Yes, Marco, thank you very much for the question. For the first moment during the pilot, we definitely don't use the software, because it is a developing the method inside the company. As the method is very standardized, implementation is very different industry per industry, company per company. But after pilot, during the rollout, companies are using to develop some software, but these softwares are usually done closely to companies' ERP system or some other manufacturing system they are using. But yes, we during the practical life, we use the software, because it's not possible to manage such a huge company like a Bosch by papers. Thanks, Darko, for invitation. Okay. So we are also thank you very much, and we would like to ask you. To don't hesitate to contact Imrich Pap. Your contact numbers are in presentation. Presentation will be also possible to send you by Darko. And now I would like to stop our presentation. I hope it was for you interesting. And Darko, it's your time. Thank you very much organizing that webinar, and I am glad that people were before the Christmas coming to us. Thank you.
Thank you, Jitka, and all of you. I will proceed in Serbian just to close the webinar and to announce some future events. Thank you once again, and welcome to Serbia, and I'm looking forward to hear you on the next webinar. Hvala svima. Zaista moram da kažem hvala, zato što je ovo vreme svakako, već smo imali te diskusije, veoma nezgodno za svakog od vas, i zato još više cenimo vaše prisustvo na današnjem webinaru. Molio bih vas da odvojite 2 do 3 minuta vremena da nam date povratne informacije, iz prostog razloga, eto, da bismo naredni put malo više možda izašli u susret vašim potrebama, kako u odnosu na teme, tako i u odnosu na vreme u koje ovaj ili slični webinari treba da budu organizovani da bi, kažem, bili u najboljem trenutku za vas. Kao što je već rečeno, pratite nas na LinkedIn stranici Link Consulting Srbija. Uskoro sledi više informacija o narednim događajima u 2021. godini. Kao što ste čuli, ovo je početak saradnje sa TWI institutom za centralnu Evropu i opšte institutom na globalnom nivou, tako da ćemo ponuditi i neke obuke koje su predmet sertifikacije i ne samo to, kao što ste upoznati ili evo sada trenutak da vas upoznam, od januara ove godine mi smo članica MTM asocijacije i u ovom trenutku radimo na tome da i obuke koje su namenjene sertifikaciji za MTM budu dostupne u Srbiji. Kažem, očekujte eto novosti. Hvala još jednom, veliko hvala zapravo na ovom učešću i eto očekujte pozive i vidimo se na narednim događajima. Kažem, veliko hvala i vama i eto nadam se da ste dobili neku dodatnu vrednost nakon ovog webinara. Veliki pozdrav za sve.